Welcome to this presentation. I will be going through 25 multiple choice questions covering different aspects of psychology. Each MCQ has four options, of which one is correct. Brief explanations related to the questions will be provided. Question 1. Which of the following is correct regarding the trail making test? During this test, the examiner is allowed to point out errors made by the subject. The test consists of four parts, A, B, C, and D. It is also called the Stroop test. Part A is a test of executive functioning. And the correct answer is A. During this test, the examiner is allowed to point out errors made by the subject. B is false because the test consists of two parts only, A and B. C is false because the trail making test is different from the Stroop test. And D is false because it is part B, which is a test of executive functioning, while part A is a test of cognitive processing speed. In the trail making test part A, the subject is asked to connect 25 consecutive numbers from 1 to 25 as quickly as possible. In part B, the subject is asked to connect 25 items alternating between 13 numbers 1 to 13, and 12 alphabets A to L. Most complete part A within 90 seconds, while most complete part B within 180 seconds. The examiner can point out errors during the test, allowing the subject to correct, but this would be reflected in the increased time that is taken to complete the test. Impaired performance is seen in a range of different disorders. This is part A, where the subject has to connect consecutive numbers 1, 2, 3, and so on. And this is part B, where the subject has to connect alternating numbers and alphabets. So 1A, 2B, 3C, etc. Question 2. Which of the following is not correct regarding memory? Episodic memory and semantic memory are types of explicit memory. Explicit memory is also called declarative memory. Explicit memory and implicit memory are types of short-term memory. Implicit memory is also called procedural memory. And the correct answer is C. So C is the statement which is not correct regarding memory. The other three statements are correct. Explicit and implicit memory are types of long-term memory. So this figure shows the different types of memory: sensory memory, short-term memory, long-term memory, which is further divided into explicit conscious or declarative memory and implicit unconscious or procedural memory. The explicit memory is further divided into episodic memory, which is the memory for experiences and events, and semantic memory, which is the memory for facts and concepts. Question 3. Which of the following is correct regarding intelligence? An individual's peak IQ is seen around the age of 36. Fluid intelligence and crystallized intelligence are the two main types of intelligence. The average IQ, as measured by testing, is slightly higher in females than in males. The Flynn effect refers to the decrease in IQ that is seen as an individual grows older. And the correct answer is B. Fluid intelligence and crystallized intelligence are the two main types of intelligence. A is false because an individual's peak IQ is seen around the age of 26. C is false because the average IQ is slightly higher in males. And D is false because the Flynn effect refers to the increase in the average IQ of the population by about 3 points every decade that has been seen over the course of the last several decades. Question 4. The figure shown below is part of which of the following tests? Is it the Ray-Osterhage test, the Rorschach test, the Stroop test, or the Wisconsin test? And the correct answer is it is the Ray-Osterhage test. So this test is also called the Ray-Osterhage complex figure test. In this test, the subject is asked to copy a complex line drawing. The test is done in three stages. The first stage is copy, where the subject copies the figure while seeing it. And the second and third stages are recall stages. The second stage is immediate recall, which is done after a few seconds, where the subject is asked to draw the figure from memory. And delayed recall is tested after 20 to 30 minutes. The copy test assesses visuospatial ability and attention, while the recall test assesses working memory and visual memory. And this test is used to assess cognitive impairment, brain injury, and cognitive development in children. The scoring takes into account a set number of elements in the figure and looks in presence, completeness, and correct placement of the elements. Question 5. Which Gestalt law of perception is demonstrated by the picture below? Is it closure, continuity, proximity, or similarity? And the correct answer is A. Closure. That the whole is different from or greater than the sum of its individual parts is the basis of gestalt psychology. The gestalt laws of perception include closure. Closed figures are more easily perceived than incomplete ones. Continuity. Continuous patterns are more easily perceived than discontinuous ones. Proximity. Elements occurring close to each other are perceived as being together rather than as being separate. Similarity, where similar figures are perceived as being together. So this image is an example of closure. So this image is actually not a closed image. There are gaps in the image, but we tend to perceive it as a whole image of a giant panda. So this is the logo of the World Wildlife Fund. Similarly, this is another image that is not complete, but we tend to see it as a closed image of a football. This figure illustrates continuity. So we tend to see this image as consisting of a straight line and a wavy line rather than as a series of semicircles. This image illustrates proximity. So we are more likely to perceive this image as three pairs of two vertical lines each, rather than as six separate vertical lines. And this figure illustrates similarity. So we are likely to perceive this image as alternating columns of crosses and knots, rather than as rows containing alternating crosses and knots. Question 6. Which of the following is not a test of frontal lobe function? Is it the digit span test, the Luria's test, the proverb interpretation test, or the verbal fluency test, FAS test? The correct answer is A. A is not a test of frontal lobe function, while the other three are. A is a test of verbal working memory. Question 7. The Turing test is concerned with addictive behavior, artificial intelligence, perception, or social attitudes. And the correct answer is B, artificial intelligence. So the Turing test was developed by the British computer scientist Alan Turing. This test is concerned with artificial intelligence and attempts to answer the question, can a machine think? In the standard Turing test, the so-called interrogator C asks questions to players A and B, one of whom is a human and the other a computer. And the interrogator C has to determine, based on the answers given by A and B, as to who is the computer. And this is the setup that is used in a Turing test. Question 8. Which of the following is not part of Piaget's stages of cognitive development? abstract operational stage, formal operational stage, pre-operational stage, or sensory motor stage? And the correct answer is A. Abstract operational stage is not part of Piaget's stages of cognitive development. The first stage is the sensory motor stage, followed by the pre-operational stage, the concrete operational stage, and the formal operational stage. Question 9. Which of the following is the final one in Erikson's stages of development? Is it autonomy versus shame, basic trust versus mistrust, integrity versus despair, or intimacy versus isolation? And the correct answer is C. Integrity versus despair. This is the final stage. And in this slide, I have listed the 8 stages of development according to Erik Erikson. Starting from the first stage, which is the basic trust versus mistrust stage, and going up towards the final stage, which is integrity versus despair. Question 10. In operant conditioning, which of the following reinforcement schedules is most resistant to extinction? Is it fixed interval, fixed ratio, variable interval, or variable ratio? And the correct answer is D. Variable ratio. So, variable ratio reinforcement is most resistant to extinction. There are different types of reinforcement in operant conditioning. In continuous reinforcement, every response gets predictably reinforced. So, this type of reinforcement is the least resistant to extinction. The other types include fixed interval, fixed ratio, variable interval, and variable ratio. And variable ratio reinforcement is the most resistant to extinction. Question 11. Which of the following is not a type of classical conditioning? Is it backward, punishment, simultaneous, or trace? And the correct answer is B. So, punishment is not a type of classical conditioning. It is a type of operant conditioning. So, in forward classical conditioning, the conditioned stimulus is presented before the unconditioned stimulus. In backward classical conditioning, the conditioned stimulus is presented after the unconditioned stimulus. In simultaneous conditioning, CS and UCS are presented together, while in trace conditioning, conditioned stimulus is presented but removed before the unconditioned stimulus is presented. Question 12. The case of Kitty Genovese is cited in psychology textbooks while discussing about the concept of amnesia, bystander intervention, prejudice, or problem solving. And the correct answer is B, bystander intervention. So Kitty Genovese, a 28-year-old, was murdered outside her own home in the borough of Queens in New York in March 1964. Although up to 37 people witnessed her being stabbed, none reportedly called the police. Her case has influenced the social psychological concept of bystander intervention, which is the study of factors which determine whether strangers will intervene when they witness an untoward incident. And this was how the New York Times reported that incident. Question 13. Which of the following is not a theory of emotion? Is it Broadbent's filter theory, Cannon Bard theory, James Lang theory, or Schachter's cognitive labeling theory? And the correct answer is A, Broadbent's filter theory. So this is not a theory of emotion, it is a theory of attention. Question 14. Which of the following is not an attachment type in the original strange situation test developed by Mary Ainsworth? Is it insecure avoidant, insecure resistant, insecure disorganized, or secure? And the correct answer is C, insecure disorganized. So this is not a type originally suggested by Mary Ainsworth. This category was introduced later by Maynard Solomon. The description, the transmission of thoughts from one mind to another without using language, gesture, or any of the senses, applies to which of the following parapsychological phenomena? Is it clairvoyance, precognition, telepathy, or telekinesis? And the correct answer is C, telepathy. So in this slide, I have listed the four main types of parapsychological phenomena: clairvoyance, which is the ability to know information that is not accessible to any senses or anyone else; precognition, which is the ability to know information about future events; telekinesis or psychokinesis, which is the ability of the mind to move distant objects without employing any physical means; and telepathy, which is the transmission of thoughts from one mind to another without using language, gesture, or any of the senses. Question 16. Which of the following is correct regarding classical conditioning and operant conditioning? Both are voluntary. In classical conditioning, reinforcement is contingent on behavior, more behaviors can be conditioned by classical conditioning than by operant conditioning. And operant conditioning is also called instrumental conditioning. And the correct answer is D. So D is true while the other three are not. A is false because it is only operant conditioning which is voluntary while classical conditioning is involuntary. B is false because it is in operant conditioning that reinforcement is contingent on behavior. And C is false because it is the other way around. So more behaviors can be conditioned by operant conditioning than by classical conditioning. Question 17. The law of effect is associated with which of the following? Is it Pavlov, Skinner, Thorndike, or Watson? And the correct answer is Thorndike. So the law of effect is associated with Thorndike. According to this law, responses that lead to reward are strengthened, while responses that lead to no reward or responses that lead to punishment are weakened. Thorndike demonstrated this with his puzzle box. So this was Thorndike's puzzle box. So the cat is placed in the box with the reward of food outside beyond its reach. In due course, the cat learns that pressing a lever will result in getting out of the box and being able to reach the food. Question 18. The fan effect is a concept relating to memory, motivation, pattern recognition, or problem solving. And the correct answer is A, memory. So the fan effect is a concept relating to memory and particularly retrieval of information. According to this effect, it takes longer to retrieve a specific bit of information about a particular topic the more you know about that topic. A related concept is the paradox of interference, which states that the more you know about a particular topic, the harder it is to remember details about that topic. Question 19. In vision, which of the following is not a binocular cue? Accommodation, convergence, retinal disparity, stereopsis. And the correct answer is A, accommodation. So accommodation is a monocular cue. The binocular cues are convergence, which refers to the eyes turning inwards while focusing on an object that is getting closer. Retinal disparity, as the two eyes are separated by about 3 inches, the two retinal images are different. This disparity gives a clue regarding distance and depth. And in stereopsis, the two-dimensional images from the left and right eyes are fused to form a single three-dimensional image. Question 20. The visual cliff is used to study color perception, depth perception, face recognition, or vertigo. And the correct answer is B, depth perception. So the visual cliff is used to study depth perception. And this is a pictorial representation of the visual cliff. Question 21. Which of the following is not part of the Halstead-Reitan neuropsychological battery of tests? Is it the category test, finger tapping test, N-BAC test, or the rhythm test? And the correct answer is N-BAC test. So this is not part of the Halstead-Reitan neuropsychological battery of tests. So this battery of tests was developed by Ward Halstead and Ralph Reitan. It is commonly used in neuropsychological studies. There are 10 tests in this battery: aphasia screening, category, finger tapping, lateral dominance, rhythm, sensory perceptual, speech sounds perception, strength of grip, tactual performance, and trail making. Question 22. To produce the strongest conditioned response, the time interval between the conditioned stimulus and the unconditioned stimulus should be 0.1 second, 0.5 second, 1 second, or 5 seconds. And the correct answer is 0.5 seconds. So this is the time interval that produces the strongest conditioned response. So ringing the bell half a second before presenting the food would elicit the maximal response, which is salivation, compared to other time intervals. Question 23. Which of the following is the final stage in Maslow's hierarchy of needs? Esteem needs, love and belonging needs, safety needs, or self-actualization needs? And the correct answer is D, self-actualization needs. And this figure shows the different needs. It starts from the most basic physiological needs and goes up and ends in self-actualization means. Question 24. The cocktail party effect is related to the psychology of addictive behavior in alcoholics, groupthink, selective attention, or social etiquette. And the correct answer is C, selective attention. The cocktail party effect is related to the concept of selective attention. In a cocktail party, a number of small groups will be holding their own conversations. This effect refers to the ability to focus one's auditory attention selectively only on the conversation that one is engaged in by filtering out the voices that are involved in the other conversations in the room. The final question, which of the following statements is referring to the fundamental attribution error? So I have listed four statements. Please pause and go through the statements and select your option. And the correct answer is C, giving more importance to personal than situational factors while explaining the behaviors of others is called the fundamental attribution error. Attributing one's actions to external factors but attributing the actions of others to internal factors is called the actor-observer bias. Attributing successes to one's character but failure to external factors is called the self-serving bias. The view that the world is inherently just and that good and bad things happen to those who deserve the same is called the just world hypothesis. And that brings us to the end of this presentation. Hope you found the material useful. Thank you for watching.